Christmas is about rescue from bitter enemies. No, say the Christmas movies, the Christmas decorations, the Christmas songs playing in the shopping malls. No, Christmas is all about goodwill and peace and everyone being nice to one another. Christmas is about friendship, neighborliness, family cheer, and kissing under the mistletoe. It has nothing to do with enmity. Don't spoil Christmas by talking about hatred. Ah, but we must. Christmas is about the people of God being rescued from those who hate them. Zechariah's boy will announce a great rescue. Zechariah, filled with the Holy Spirit, sings of God's people being redeemed, a word which harks back to when the Israelites were brought out of slavery in the Egypt of the Pharaohs. He sings of a horn of salvation, which means a strong rescuer, in the house of God's servant David, that is, a king in David's line. This rescuer will be a strong king to set God's people free. Zechariah celebrates the arrival of salvation from our enemies and from the hand of all who hate us, and rescue from the hand of our enemies. He delights in the hope that at last God's people will be free to serve him without fear, just as the Hebrew slaves in Egypt were set free to worship the Lord their God at Mount Sinai after the Exodus. But what does this mean? Many hearing this will not feel that they are surrounded by people who hate them, although some will. We may want to skim over this part of Zechariah's song and get on to the bits that connect with our experience. Yet, to do so would be foolish, for every Christian has a great enemy who is a murderer and a liar and the father of lies. He tempted Adam and Eve so that they walked headfirst into the shadow of death. Satan loves to steal and kill and destroy. He spoils lives with sin, with sickness, with fighting, with bitterness, and ultimately with death. The devil is a real and terrible enemy. But there is more. What the Bible sometimes calls the world, men and women living in God's world without submitting to God, loving God, or caring about God, has its heart a deep hostility to all who belong to God and God's Son, the King in David's line. Right back near the beginning of Genesis, Cain hated his brother Abel because Abel was a man of faith who trusted God. And Cain set the tone for a long and dark tradition of hostility towards those who truly belong to God. Many of our brothers and sisters around the world know what it is to face bitter persecution and hatred for belonging to Jesus Christ. Some of us live in lands where that hostility lies below the surface. We must not be surprised when it comes out into the open, and we must remember that all of us were by nature among those enemies before Jesus laid his hands on us and made us God's friends. Yet there is an even closer enemy than the devil and the world. Right inside ourselves, like a spy or terrorist who infiltrates our very heart, what the Bible calls our flesh fights against our souls and spiritual lives. We face bitter hostility from the world, the flesh, and the devil. And Jesus came to rescue us. The reason the Son of God appeared was to destroy the devil's work. The more deeply we are aware of these enemies, the more we will join Zechariah in glad songs of praise. Jesus came at the first Christmas so that by his obedient life and sin-bearing death, he might rescue us from all our enemies. Take time to think. In what ways do you feel the oppression of the world, the flesh, and the devil today? How does it most hurt? In what ways can you feel dark hostility? Remember, Christmas is about enemies, but thank God, Jesus has come. And hold on, he is coming soon.
Let us pray. Our Father, as we long for that day when we will finally be set free from all our enemies, we pray for many of those enemies of the gospel to become friends of God, as Saul of Tarsus was so wonderfully converted, and we cry with the church of every age, Come, Lord Jesus. And we rejoice as we hear his answering call, I am coming soon. Amen.